We have millions of acres of traditional crops like corn and soybeans all over Minnesota. But that's not all. We have hundreds of thousands of acres of specialty crops like berries and grapes and pumpkins. Our Josh Rosenthal is live in Falcon Heights tonight, where he breaks down what a new specialty crop study means for farmers. Josh.
Yeah, Ellen, corn, like what you see behind me, is a traditional crop. A lot of the times it's not all that profitable on a per acre basis, but demand is very high. Specialty crops are more like cantaloupe, pumpkin, and apple. With these, as the new report shows, profitability is very high, but these guys can be a lot more work to grow.
These are the last ones for this year.
Alec Pelavskyi sells all sorts of fruits and vegetables 6 days a week at the Minneapolis Farmers Market. Deciding what to plant every year can be a challenge.
Different years are different, and you know, never know what customers would like.
The Minnesota Department of Agriculture hopes to change the decision-making process by adding some hard financial data to the mix. They just released this report analyzing the profitability of specialty crops in Minnesota.
What's profitable? What isn't? What are the costs that I'm going to incur if I'm trying to budget for a crop?
The findings come from data supplied by Minnesota farmers. Take a look at this chart. Strawberries and assorted vegetables were especially profitable. Other crops, like apples and blueberries, not so much.
There's quite a bit of interest in locally grown foods right now around the populated areas. So, you know, for people who have that interest, this is important information.
But keep in mind, specialty crops might be the main source of income for some farms, but for most, they're supplemental income. Traditional row crops, like corn, that's where the real money comes from. It means people like Pelavskyi will take a look at the new report, but they won't bet the farm on it.
So if I asked you, what do you think your top-selling crop next year is going to be, what would be your answer?
I don't know, honestly. You can't tell.
Keep in mind, collecting hard financial info on specialty crops in Minnesota is still pretty new. Altogether, 55 farms contributed data to this report, so the sample size is still relatively small. Reporting live in Falcon Heights, Josh Rosenthal, 5 Eyewitness News.
Thanks, Josh. So what are the man hours, rather, needed to produce these crops? Well, that same Minnesota Department of Agriculture study found strawberries and assorted vegetables amounted to more than 300 hours per acre in 2012. For apples, it was only 210 hours per acre. Blueberries were 450 hours per acre.